There's no point to do anything anymore. AI is taking over all jobs. Why do I even bother? I'm just gonna watch TV all day. Where's my remote control? All right, now that we've had that very dramatic intro, actually, honestly, it might feel dramatic watching this video, but I think a lot of people are feeling this way still. Every day, it seems like a new technology or new AI tool is coming out that can replace, whether it be coders, UI UX designers, product managers, SEO individuals, whatever the case may be. And I understand why people get nervous or get scared when especially when you are investing a lot of time and energy into learning something new or growing your career. It can feel very overwhelming as to, is it even worth it? Is this the right way to go? I've seen so many comments on my videos recently around, what should I learn? Should I learn data science or should I learn web development? What is going to become extinct faster? And it really blows my mind. I mean, on one hand, I understand where you are coming from. You are worried, you want to learn a skill that is going to be in demand. And that is something we speak about a lot on this channel, so I get it. On the other hand though, it's one of those things that I really try and hone in on that, learn whatever you are passionate about. You will find a way to evolve and grow. You're looking at it from the wrong perspective. You're looking at a perspective of survival, where in reality, you will survive and you will thrive in your career by focusing on what you are truly passionate about and interested in. That aside though, here are some tips that I'm going to be sharing with you today to really ensure you can kind of get the best of both worlds. On one hand, that your career will be in demand, the skills that you have developed will be in demand, and on the other hand though, how you can flip the switch and really utilize AI and these tools to help you outperform all your colleagues, or whatever the case may be. Let's get into it. I need coffee. We always need coffee. When you really look ahead, think even 5-10 years from now, starting to look ahead and think about how can you stay in demand? And I'm not talking necessarily a technical skill, or even a soft skill. Let's leave skills to the side for a second here. What makes companies hire people? Well, at the end of the day, it's the classic slogan we always hear, which is people hire people. One more time, people hire people. Okay, I know you're probably thinking, Tiff, now people hire AI. But at the end of the day, we still need people. And nothing is more important. The reality is, oftentimes, I'm not saying all the time, but oftentimes, skills aside, is having that human connection. When people really enjoy speaking with you throughout the interview and can see you're really collaborative and want to be part of their team and just a all-around good human, whatever that means to them, they oftentimes hire that over someone who has these crazy skills. Obviously, skills are very important, but putting that to the side. And I'm sharing this with you, these thoughts with you, because at the end of the day, you really need to take a step back. We're on this rat race, it feels like, of what skill is most in demand, or what should I learn the fastest, or what is gonna keep me employed. Take a step back and just eliminate all skills for a second. What do people look for? Really good people. So I think I'm really honing in on this and kind of repeating myself a bit, because at the end of the day, networking is so key, building that community and support system. Now I know a lot of you, or some of you are saying, Tiff, I hate networking. You know why I know that? Because I hate networking too. But it is so key. Oftentimes when you are looking at jobs you've had in the past or future jobs, it is so much simpler to gain those jobs when you have that network. And this is something, whether you like it or not, that will continue, probably be even more important as the AI and future of tech continues to evolve. Having those connections with people, because at the end of the day, they are the ones making the decisions of who they want to hire. And if you have those ins at certain companies or are networking and really investing your time into networking, you will see it pay off. Now that being said, sometimes networking, all the time, in my opinion, just is not that fun. So here are some AI tools that can help you, especially when it comes to writing, because a lot of times for me, writing emails or just getting those conversations started is where I have that big writer's block to even initiate a call. So here you go. For me and Jack Nicholson behind me. First thing around networking, as I mentioned with emails, is it's so difficult to even just send that email. I get writer's block. So I wanted to share with you Ellie. I've been using Ellie on my other computer actually for a while now, because it really helps me, I find, when I want to send someone an email, but I have no idea how to. And this isn't sponsored by any of these tools, by the way. I just am obsessed with using tools to help me out. So you can see here, I'm on their website. It's called tryellie.com. And I'm just on their demo page. So let's do something like this. Hi, Ellie, how are you? How good are you at replying to emails? Thanks, James. Let's do this to Tiff, ask Ellie. I was thinking, it takes time. See, look how accurate this is though. Hey Tiff, I'm pretty good if I do say so myself. I'm here to help you with any emails you need. What's up? It sounds like a human wrote this, which is pretty wild. So with Ellie, let me go back to their homepage here. And you do have to, you can install it and use it for free, but then also too, depending on how many emails you wanna use with it, you do have to purchase a license, but you can install and start using it for free. But what I really like about it too, is it does have different ways to be responding. So respectful, casual, annoyed, interested, and it really helps me, even if I modify the response, at least get a response out there, get something on paper, or even if I'm reaching out to someone, get something on paper. So whether you use Ellie or a different AI tool to help you write emails, it's a really great way to unblock that friction for sending that first email to someone. All right, the other one I wanna share with you around networking is, and really just finding time to connect with others, is this personal assistant. So it's called Lindy, and I've used Lindy for a few different tasks. It's still in beta, right? Yeah. Comment down below. I told you, I'm still on my first coffee. It's still in beta format. So at the end of the day though, because I've heard people say both, so I need to clarify that. I've heard people in tech industry say beta and beta. Maybe it's like GIF or JIF. It's one of those things. But yeah, so it's really helpful for certain tasks. I don't find Lindy to help me to the point where it's actually a personal assistant per se, but I do find it helpful. The more you use this tool, the more it gets to know your habits and your requests, your calendar, and you can really use it to help you do the small things, such as scheduling invites, let me know when my next meeting will be. Let's scroll down a bit here. So one thing that I use it for is scheduling, so handles the back and forth to find common availabilities. So kind of like an email writer as well with that. Also too, this is really, really cool around pre-draft to your email. So you can actually wake up with responses to some of your emails. I mean, that's a dream to me. Wake up and this AI has already responded in draft form to the emails. I mean, that's gonna save you so much time. You can, and also to morning anxiety. Waking up knowing that these emails have drafts already written out is huge for me anyways. I'll link all these tools down below, by the way. All right, let's dive into or address the elephant in the room, which is great, Tiff. We've done our networking. We're, you know, meeting the right people. At the end of the day, you still wanna learn new skills fast. And as tech continues to evolve, you will need to learn tech at a faster pace, or these skills at a faster pace. The good news is, if you are embracing AI and using tools to help you learn faster, it won't be a problem. But if you are one of those people who are really hesitant to use it or really think negatively about incorporating some AI tools into your workflow, I'm not sure how you will be able to keep up with technology and keep up with building new skills. And the reality is, the people who are using these tools, these AI tools, to help them learn or work faster and be more productive, frees up their mind to focus on bigger tasks, bigger problems, or more complex problems. And in turn, they will be the thought leaders, the thinkers ahead. Thinkers ahead? Oh, Tiff, you're not thinking is the problem here. No, I'm still on my first cup of coffee. They will be the thought leaders of the next, of 2030, of 2040, because they are using these tools to help with the smaller tasks so they can focus on the larger tasks. Think about the big picture. So there are so many different AI tools that you can utilize today, whether you are a coder, whether you are a UI UX designer. Okay, you know what? Let's dive into some of them. All right, this tool is going to be a game changer. And I know what you're thinking, Tiff, this is gonna take out front-end developers. No, it's not. What it will do is, once again, these designs that will turn into React code, at the end of the day, it's not perfect. It still needs to be implemented. But it is a really wild thing to think about the direction this is going. So this is called Bitfrost, and it's still in alpha testing right now. But what it will do is turn your Figma designs into clean React code. So let's watch a little video here.
Hi, I'm the CEO and co-founder of Figma.
Hi.
And this is the first.
So let's scroll a little bit.
And here is Frost. You can go to record data, press enter. Just wait a couple seconds, and there you go. Let it save, and you will see that component 1-to-1.
It's wild. This is really interesting as to when you think about the future, not only for coders, but also to designers, and how these roles will closely merge. And that's what I'm getting at throughout all this video, hopefully to you, is you need to start somewhere. You need to have that knowledge. So don't worry about what skills are gonna be Don't focus on your learnings on what's going to be in demand in 5 years from now or 10 years from now. Focus on what you're interested in, because with that foundation, you will naturally evolve with these tools, as long as you're open to using them. This is a really cool one. All right, one other one I wanted to share with you, I mean, there are tons out there, so I'm trying to share different ones with you, is Build with AI Club. Now, this is not a free tool, let's start off by saying that, but what it does do is it's a course that will teach you how to build no code or low code apps with AI. So this is really interesting to me. So if you go to courses here, you can see, say, course basics. So you will learn to build an AI web app. So with a simple one-page AI web app with Zapier and OpenAI by building an AI dream decoder. So it's really interesting to think about this new level, this new wave of technologists that are coming out that are using AI and low and no code tools to build really quickly. And I think we will see more of that progressing, this merge of so many different roles coming together. So this is another interesting tool, or course, I guess I should say, that you can utilize to really take your skills to the next level. Just because you do one thing today, you're in one role today, as tech advances, it definitely doesn't mean you will be doing that in 2 or 3 years. You need to be open to evolving and growing in your career and skill set. All right, we made it to the end. I hope you enjoyed not only hearing some thoughts around how the future of AI or future of tech will affect your skill sets and where to put your attention. If you take anything away from this video, I hope it's two things. The first being, put your attention to what you are actually passionate about. Take AI away, because that will find its way into every role and every career. It's not just related to what you're interested in. Maybe you think that though because you just heard about a new tool coming out that's gonna take over data scientists or take over web developers. Well, tomorrow there will be another tool that takes over lawyers. There's tools coming out every day. Focus on your passion. The second thing I hope you take away from this video is to utilize AI, to embrace it. Question it, yes, we all are aware of that, but use these tools to your advantage to help you learn quicker, help you learn smarter, and also to work smarter in the sense of give it these little simple tasks so you can continue to be a thought leader. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave down below any thoughts you have around this video, questions. I do my best to answer every single one. Also too, let me know what else you want to see. What other tech, coding, career-related videos would you find helpful? All right. Oh, and hit that subscribe button. Bye, everyone.